All right, short week this week. And of course, we're bringing this to you on Wednesday. Wherever you're watching, I hope that you have a happy Thanksgiving here coming soon. We've packed 5 days worth of work into three. And so we're going to close it out today.
Oh, we have. Yeah.
We'll close it out today. All right, let's jump right in. What do you say? I'll take the first couple. So we talked about this last time we went live, and we are officially in the middle of our scavenger hunt this year. So look for those red Empower Local signs. Joan Bell is joining us today. She's from our Small Biz Connection Committee, who helps put on all of this year's Empower Local scavenger hunt. And we're going to tell you a little bit more about that just at the end of this video. But look for those red Empower Local signs. They've got a 5-digit code on there. And the more codes you find, the more you log them through the texting or the Facebook Messenger app, the more entries you get to winning some of the prizes. There's a $1,000 grand prize, right? Local shopping spree, a few other smaller ones, about $100 cash prizes, and then some gift basket giveaways of kind of an assortment of things from our participating businesses. So
yeah, let me encourage you, as Wilson says, we've got more retailers and service organizations this year than ever. What a great opportunity to participate in our local community. So get ready for Christmas with our scavenger hunt.
Yep. And as we like to say, happy hunting. So, and then going on. So this is some of this, again, it's Wednesday. We're recapping some of the things that happened. Monday, we got the privilege of hosting a delegation from Guatemala, from the city of St. Vicente de Pacaya. Some of their city leadership, their mayor, their city administrator, some people from their city council, they had their delegation. They made some visits to Arkansas and maybe a couple other places, but you know, doing some benchmarking, learning from our city leadership and some of the infrastructure, and then taking that back to their city. So it was a cool experience. I don't know if Bob wanted to add anything to that.
Well, no, it was a great experience to meet these folks, and I found interesting thing about the city. They're very involved in tourism, and their tourism hook is they have inside their city limits the only active volcano in the world. And one of the draws for tourism is they bake pizza on the hot lava. And we've actually talked to a couple of people that went there and did that, and they say it's great. So we hope that we can connect with the city in the future. What a great opportunity. Yesterday, we had the opportunity to host Bentley Story, who's the director of business development for the Arkansas Economic Development Commission in Little Rock. He and two of his new project managers were in Harrison to meet with community leaders, learn about who we are, what we do, and how we do it. We spent a few minutes together over lunch, talked about a number of activities and organizations and the economic momentum that we have here in the city and the county. And then we took them on a driving tour that included all of those momentum locations, Creekside Community Center, our industry, Industrial Park Road, the move of Claridge. We spent quite a bit of time at the Boone County Regional Airport learning about the opportunities for increasing their value to us from an economic perspective. So it was our pleasure to host Bentley Story and Jared and Olivia from AEDC. We look forward to doing more of that this coming year.
You know, just how important, I don't think we can stress the importance enough of, you know, that's like a trial run for us, being able to take people on a tour of the community.
Absolutely.
Talk about how important first impressions are of a community. Like if we have business prospects that are here, and what do we show them, and who's in the van with us, who's helping us tell the story of Harrison and the momentum and economic activity.
Yeah.
And
excellent.
That was so healthy for us to do that.
Excellent point. The more we can do this, the better we're going to be for the real thing when it comes.
Right.
And we're also educating the folks who deal with this on a national and global level from AEDC. So great opportunity. And lastly, like most local businesses, the chamber is going to be closed tomorrow for Thanksgiving and the day after. The day after is to attend the Arkansas Razorback game where the Hogs will beat the Tigers of Missouri. But tomorrow we want to note the special day that Thanksgiving is to us as a chamber staff here and our board of directors. We want to pause give thanks for the many things that we enjoy in this community, in the region, in the state, and nationally and globally. We're very fortunate to have all of these things, and tomorrow we pause to give thanks, and we'll see you bright and early Monday morning.
So actually, I said at the beginning of the video that Joan was going to join us. We're going to talk about Empower Local. Actually, we're not going to do that. Here live, we've made an audible. We're calling an audible. And we're going to show the GobTV project video at our economic summit with Stuart Walton, presented by North Arkansas College. We had GobTV there, and they did some coverage. They could do some interviews and some B-roll of what's going on. So they did this as a part of their class at the high school with Rebecca Crow and the GobTV program there. And so let's show you the final version of that as well. Yeah. Highlight. So shout out.
That's God. Great.
Today we are here at the Economic Development Summit with local leaders in our community. Let's take a look at the development and innovation being talked about today.
We're pleased to have with us this morning Stuart Walton, who is founder of the Runway Group in Northwest Arkansas.
I think you can leverage your location between sort of the Branson-Springfield corridor and the Northwest Arkansas corridor and really begin to kind of think about how you attract people from both of those metropolitan areas to Harrison, either maybe first to visit and then maybe to live.
The video really captured what you guys have in spades, and quite frankly, the natural beauty over here, proximity to the lakes, the Ozarks, hills. You're more well-equipped to serve outdoor enthusiasts.
So we're here in the Durand Center, and we've got business leaders and economic developers, and they're going through a process of trying to assess the local venture and startup scene. So they're asking really hard questions about what's the current state of talent, what's the entrepreneurial culture like, what's the capital like, and how engaged is the community. It's a process to understand where you are so that you can create entrepreneurial programs and have a better business community.
Think about the people that you're trying to attract. You're trying to attract those outdoor enthusiasts, those entrepreneurs, those young creative types. And what are they going to like? They're going to like coffee shops and restaurants, a place that they can experience art or make art, things like that. And so figuring out that holistic picture of what you have, who's around you, how to get them to come visit, and then keep going down that road.
Today we're working on a venture ecosystem building canvas, and so through our book Creating Startup Junkies, we've outlined a canvas that communities can use to build entrepreneurial ecosystems. And so they do that through four pillars, and so the community right now is identifying what the assets and the strengths are, and then also the gaps in those four pillar areas that help build entrepreneurial ecosystems, and looking at ways that you can innovate and change your local community, but then also create a path for yourself as you grow in life.
Entrepreneurship is a mindset of challenging the status quo, and the only constraints that really matter are the ones that you're willing to accept, so don't accept them. Figure out something big and chase it.
With GobTV, I'm Alexa Ramsey.